Now, the Department of Women, Youth and Persons with Disability, in partnership with the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, launched the 2024 Women's Month campaign. During the launch, the department outlined its stride in women's empowerment and emancipation, while also unpacking the overall government's plan for this year's commemoration of Women's Month.
Isebe labasekhini ulutsha kunye nabantu abakhubazekileyo libambisene nesebe lezemidlalo. Ubugcisa nenkcubeko anike ingxelo kumalungu onondaba ngephulo lenyanga yabasetyhini yalo nyaka. Iintlelo eziqingqelwe abasetyhini kulo nyaka zinqiyame kumxholo othi ukubhiyozela iminyaka engamashumi amathathu yenkululeko esingise kuphuhliso lwabasetyhini.
We are launching the Women's Month. Remember, in South Africa, 9 August is a commemoration of women who marched in 1956. But South Africa took a decision that they will commemorate that through the whole month. And what it means is that every government should implement some activities to showcase what they've done in order to empower women, youth and persons with disabilities.
Isebe labasetyhini ulutsha kunye nabantu abakhubazekileyo libuye lacangcatha kwizicwangciso zizonke zephulo lenyanga yabasetyhini yalo nyaka.
Every government department and all the provinces, they have activities. We have a calendar of events. But the ones that I can raise now, you know, many people are not, black people, more especially black young persons, are not involved in printing, your 3D printing and all those. Today, as I speak in Cape Town, we have a workshop where Printing South Africa is training young persons. We're working with them. They will be going to all the provinces in order to empower young persons to be involved in printing. Most of the printing companies that you see are owned by whites. Most, there might be black people, but there are very few.
Ekunikeni amanina iqonga lokuba aqame nawo ayakhuthazwa ukuba aphume elubala ukukhangela amathuba kwaye axhamle kuwo. Kwiindaba zeSoweto TV, ndingunomzabalazo Mduka ePitoli.